Good morning, students. In today's class, we are going to solve exercise 2.3 few questions. Okay. In this exercise 2.3 few questions, I am going to solve here. Others, you have other problems. You have to try yourself. Now, see, students. The first question is that state which pairs of triangles are similar. Okay, we have to tell which pairs of triangles are similar. They are given so many pairs, but I took first one here. State which pairs of triangles are similar. Write the similarity criterion used by you for answering the question, and also write the pairs of similar triangles in the symbolic. We have to tell. You have to tell here if the triangles are similar. We have to tell which criterion we have used, and we have to write in this in symbolic form. In last class, we have studied about criterion of similarity of triangles, right? We have learned angle, side, angle, side. By keeping that in mind, we will solve this problem. Now, see our first one. They have asked, is these two triangles are similar? Is these two triangles are similar? They have given only angle for us, right? They have given only angle for us. We will just check whether these two triangles are similar or no. See, here angle A and angle P are same. Angle A is equal to angle P. Again, angle B is equal to angle Q. That is 80 degree. Angle C is equal to angle R, that is 40 degree. We can tell that these two triangles are similar. These two triangles are similar. By which criterion we have used here? Angle. By angle criterion of similarity, we can tell that these two triangles are similar. So, write down the solution. First one, angle A is equal to angle P, that is 60 degree. Angle B is equal to angle Q, that is 80 degree. Angle C is equal to angle R, that is 40 degree. Therefore, triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. By AA similarity criterion, these two triangles are similar. So we will see the second one question, what they are given in the textbook, that is exercise 2.3 ABC 2.5. P, Q, R, 5, 4, 6. Now, see, students. Now, in second question, they have given sides. Now, here we have to see the corresponding sides. Okay? We have to check for the corresponding sides, whether they are in the same ratio, because they are not given any angle. Now we will see solution. Now see, students, there is no any condition that AB you have to compare with PR only. No, we have to take a same quantity. We can take a same quantity. See, here I can AB by RQ. AB they have given 2. And RQ they have given 4. The answer will be 1/2. And AC KC by PR. PR 3 by 6. It is also 1 by 2. Now, BC by, okay, BC by PQ. BC is 2.5 by 5. 2.5 ones are 2.5, 2 is 5, 1 by 2. See here, corresponding sides are in the same ratio. Therefore, what we can tell here is triangle ABC is similar to triangle, RQT by SSS similarity criterion. Now see here, student, before in session 2 class we have learned that for similarity of triangles we have to see the 6 elements, yes or no? 3 triangles we have to check and 3 corresponding sides we have to check whether they all are same, whether they all are equal, 6 elements. Now in last class we have learned that criterion for similarity of triangles. Our work will become so easy, we come to know at once whether the triangles are similar or no, yes or no, by using the criterion for similarity of triangle, that is angle, side. Okay, we will take the next question. Now see a student, this is the third figure in your textbook. This one is the third one. 4, 5, 6. Now see here, students. Again they are given sides here. Okay. Again they have given side, we will find the ratio of the corresponding sides whether are in the same ratio or no. See here, solutions, we compare MP by DE. MP is 2, DE is 4, it will come 1 by 2. LP by DF, that is 3 by 6 is 1 by 2. LM by AF, LM is 2.7 by 5. See you, students. Here we are getting 1 by 2, but here it is getting 2.7 by 5. The answer is different. Here the corresponding sides are in not in the same ratio. Therefore, these two triangles are not similar. What we can tell is that these two triangles are not similar. Okay. Therefore, triangle LMP and triangle FED are not similar. So these two triangles are not similar because here the ratio of the corresponding sides are not in the same ratio. Here we are getting 1 by 2, but here it is differing. So next we will see the fifth one. Next we will see fifth one, what they have given. A, B, C, 2.5, 3, 80 degrees. Now this is the fifth one. Okay. Now see your students. Here all angles they have not given, only one angle is given. If at least two angles they are given, definitely we used to check whether the corresponding angles are equal. Okay, they are not given angles. And the second thing is SSS, all sides they have not given here, all sides they have not given here, means definitely it will, we can't go for SSS criteria of similarity. Next, one more thing remaining is that we will check for, we will go whether side angle side it will follow. See here, by seeing the triangles, by seeing these figures, we can definitely tell that these two triangles are not similar. See here, concentrate your students. Here, yes, A, yes, to be followed, angle A should be included. Here this angle is not included, but here this angle is included between the two sides. Yes or no? It will won't follow angle, side. Okay, they are not given angles also, sides also. If you want to check for side angle side, they have not given here AC. It should be, if they have given AC, we would have checked it. Okay, these two triangles are not similar. These two triangles are not, these two triangles are not similar. Yes or no? If they had given at least this, we would have gone for checking. But here it will won't follow any criteria. Definitely these two triangles are not similar. So next we will go for the second question. Next we will see the second question, what they have given in the textbook. Second question we will see. See the second one. In figure ODC is similar to, sorry, it is a triangle, in figure triangle ODC is similar to triangle OBA, angle BOC is equal to 125 degree, and angle CDO is equal to 70 degree. Find angle DCO and angle OAB. DCO This is 125 degree they have given, and here 70 degree. Now see, students, in figure O, triangle ODC, triangle ODC and OBA, OBA are similar. These two triangles are similar triangles. Again, they have given angle BOC is equal to 125 degree. BOC they have given 125 degree. And angle CDO, CDO they have given 70 degree. Find DOC. We have to find this angle here. We have to find our first angle DOC. Now see, a student, observe carefully. Here DOB is a straight line. Yes or no? DOB is a straight line. What we can tell? Angle BOC plus angle COD will going to be 180 degree. BOD is a straight line in which angle BOC plus COD is equal to 180 degree. See, yeah? Solution: DOB is straight line, right? What we can write here? It is a straight line. Angle BOC, angle BOC plus angle COD is equal to 180 degree. Okay, or DOC both are same. Now see here, what they are given? Angle BOC is 125 degree. BOC 125 degree plus COD is equal to 180 degree. This implies COD is equal to 180 degree minus 125 degree. 180 minus 125 is 55 degree. Means this implies DOC is equal to 55 degree. This is the first one what they have told. COD, angle COD and angle DOC, same things those are. Now we have find out DOC is over. Next, we have to find out DCO. We have to find out DC. This angle we come to know that is 55 degree. This angle we come to know 55 degree. In triangle DOC, in triangle DOC, angle D is 70 degree, angle DOC is 55 degree. We have to find out angle C by angle sum property. Right on. In triangle DOC, angle DOC plus DOC plus CDO plus angle DCO is equal to 180 degree. Which property? Angle sum property. The sum of our angles of a triangle will going to be a 180 degree. Now see here, DOC. What is DOC? 55 degree plus CDO. CDO is 70 degree plus angle DCO. We have to find out this is equal to 180 degree. This implies 55 plus 70 is 125 degree plus DCO is equal to 180 degree. Now see, this implies angle DCO is equal to 180 degree minus 125 degree. This implies angle DCO, 180 minus 125 is 55 degree. We got angle DCO also. Okay, again what they are told? To find OAD. They are told to find out this angle now. OAB. They are told to find out angle OAB. This angle we have to find out. Since they have given triangle ODC similar to triangle OBA, these two triangles are similar. If these two triangles are similar, definitely corresponding angles will going to be equal. Write down. It is given that triangle ODC is similar to triangle OBA. They are given these two triangles are similar. This triangle and this triangle. If these two triangles are similar, definitely their corresponding angles will going to be equal. What we can tell? See, they are given similar. Angle O corresponds to angle O. Angle D corresponding to angle B. And angle C will correspond to angle A. I told no. Whenever we will write, if two triangles are similar, you have to keep in mind. Here they only have given, no problem. Here O will corresponds to O. D will corresponds to B. And C will corresponds to A. Now see here. Here, what is the value of angle C we have found out here? Here angle C is nothing but a 55 degree. Here angle C and angle A will be equal because these two are corresponding angles. Right on. Therefore, OAB is equal to OCD. Now see a story. Here OAB and OCD, these two are, listen to my point clearly. Here these two are these two angles are equal because corresponding angles are equal in a similar triangles. They have given already in question these two are similar triangles. These two are similar triangles they have given. Angle C corresponds to angle A. Therefore, angle OAB is equal to, that is 55 degree. Because what is the reason? Corresponding angles are equal. Where? In a similar triangle. Okay. This was about the second question. We will see now the next problem. Now the fourth question tells us that in figure QR by QS is equal to QT by PR and angle 1 and angle 2 they have given equal. Show that PQS, we have to show that PQS is similar to triangle TQR. See, solution, what we have to show here is, now see here students carefully, PQS is similar to triangle TQR. We have to show this. These two triangles are similar, we have to show in this problem. So before that, they have given that here angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Angle 1 is equal to angle 2. See here, in a triangle PQR, what they are given in triangle P PQR they have given angle 1 is equal to angle 2. This is the given thing. Angle 1 is equal to angle 2. This is the given thing. Students, we knew that in last class I told that if two angles are equal in a triangle, if two angles are equal in a triangle, their opposite side will going to be equal. See, angle 1 opposite side is AC, angle 2 opposite side is AB. Therefore, AC is equal to AB. If two angles are equal in a triangle, their opposite sides will going to be equal. Conversely, if two sides are equal in a triangle, their opposite angle will also going to be equal. Right? Now, this property we are going to use here. Now, see here angle 1. See, this is a triangle, right? PQR is a triangle. PQ opposite, say angle 1 opposite side is PR. We can tell that PR is equal to angle 2 opposite side is PQ. What we can tell is PQ is equal to PR. PQ is equal to PR. This is equal, call it as equation number 1. Angle 1 is equal to angle 2. From this we, what we can write, PQ is equal to PR, equation 1. Also QR by QS is equal to QT by PR. This is also given. Now see students, QR by QS, QT by PR. From 1, in place of PR, can we substitute PQ? Yes. Okay. In place of, from 1, we obtain, or using 1, we obtain, see here, QR by QS is equal to QT by, see, in place of PR is substitute PQ. Call it as equation number 2. So actually we want to prove here triangle TQS is similar to triangle TQR, but they have given angle 1 is equal to angle 2. From that we derived these two equations. Whatever they have given two conditions, that only have written. We are not done anything here extra. Whatever they have given, just we have represented it. Okay. Now see here we have to prove these two triangles are similar. Which are those two triangles here? P, Q. Yes, once again I am drawing it. It is Q. T, Q, these two triangles are similar, we have to prove. So now see here, in triangle PQS and triangle TQR, we can write here angle Q is equal to angle Q. Common. See, angle 1 is equal to angle 1. Again, see here, QR by QS is equal to QT by PR. QT by PQ. Now, listen here. QR by QS is equal to PQ by, these are same here. QS by QR is equal to PQ by TQ. Now see here, these 2 Qs by Qr is equal to PQ by TQ. The corresponding sides are in same ratio and here one angle is included. Here one angle is included. See here, again QR by QS is equal to QT by PQ. Yes or no? From 2. Now see here angle Q are same and we have compared these two sides, corresponding sides, and these two sides, they are in the same ratio. What we can tell that therefore triangle PQS is similar to triangle TQR. By which similarity criteria? By SAS similarity criterion. Okay, see here, once again I repeat here, in problem number 4 they told to prove these two triangles are similar. So before going to that, they have given some quantities or they have given some things, that is angle 1 is equal to angle 2. The moment we'll see angle 1 is equal to angle 2 in a triangle PQR, we can tell their opposite sides will going to be equal. Call it as equation number 1. Again, whatever they have given, in that we are substituting in place of PR, P. In place of PR, we are substituting PQ. That is equation number 2. Actually, we have to prove these two triangles are similar. Now, see, in these two triangles, angle Q is equal to angle Q. And again, QS by QR, they are given here. QR by QS is equal to QT by QP. These two corresponding sides ratios are same. Now see here, one angle is included and these corresponding sides are in the same ratio. Therefore, by SAS similarity criterion, these two triangles are similar. Okay, we will next see the 6th problem. So 6th problem, in figure, if triangle ABE is congruent to triangle ACD, show that triangle ADE is similar to triangle ABC. They are given the figure for this question. Now see students, in figure if triangle ABE, it is somewhat AB, I am drawing separately, ABE. In triangle ABE is congruent. In last year you have learned detail about congruent, and the criteria for congruency of triangle, you have studied that also. Please go for 9th standard chapter of congruency, because that is very very important. If you want to prove the triangles questions, you want the congruency idea also. It was in last year, you have to revise that part. Okay. Now see here triangle ABE is congruent to AC. सी डी, ए सी, and it is D. These two triangles are congruent. Congruent means what? What is a congruent figure? A figure which is having the same shape and same size are nothing but a congruent. Yes or no? That is the meaning of congruency. And in last year we have learned about the criteria for congruency of triangles also. Now see a solution. Given triangle ABE is congruent to triangle ACD. They have given triangle ABE is congruent to triangle ACD. If these two triangles are congruent, means definitely their sides are equal. In congruency, if two triangles are congruent, means their sides and angles are equal. Don't get confused. In congruency, if two triangles are congruent, means the angle and sides will going to be equal. But in similarity, corresponding angles will going to be equal. Second one is corresponding sides are in the same ratio. That is the difference. Here sides are equal, but in similarity corresponding sides are in the same ratio. Okay, given triangle AB is congruent to triangle ACD, therefore what we can write, AD is equal to AD and AE, right? AD and AE are same. AD and AE length is same. Again we can tell BE is equal to CD. AB is equal to AC. This is by CPCTC. You remember congruent parts of corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. If you want the correct idea about congruency, please go through 9th standard textbook. Now see here AD is equal to, this AD is equal to AE. These two are equal. BE is equal to CD and AB is equal to AC. This is by CPCTC, by CPCT. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent, because these two triangles are congruent. That's why we have written this result. Now here also, here A corresponds to A, B corresponds to C, E corresponds to D, and AB by AC will be same. BE by AB is equal to AC. AB side and AC side will be same, equal. BE is equal to CD. AE is equal to AD. Same thing I written. See, AD is equal to AE. BE is equal to CD. AB is equal to AC. Okay, this is the given thing. See, to prove, what we have to prove here? To prove triangle ADE is similar to triangle ABC. This we have to prove here. Yes? See, prove it, students. See by which criteria those two triangles will going to be similar. Now see here. In what we have to prove? Triangle ADE is similar to triangle ABC. We have to prove here ADE is similar to triangle ABC. These two triangles are similar. We have to prove. See, in a triangle A D E and triangle A B C. Now see your student. Angle A is equal to angle A. Here both angles are same. Angle A is equal to angle A. I drawn it separately. See here, angle A is equal to angle A. Now again see here. AD is equal to, see here, AD is equal to AE. AD is equal to AE and B is equal to CD and AB is equal to AC. By CPCDC, we have written these things here. Now see here students. AD is equal to AE. AD is equal to AE. AB is equal to AC. Now see here. If you take AD by AB, AD by AB is equal to AE by is equal to AE by AC. Now see here student, why I written here, these two are same, these two are same and okay, AD is equal to AE, right, AD is equal to AE and AB is equal to AC. AB is equal to AC. What I want to tell here, if AD is 1, if AD length is 1 and AE is of 1 unit you take, and if AB is of 2 unit and AC is of 2 unit, now see AD by AB, AD by AB 1 by 2 will be equal to 1 by 2. Yes or no? The ratios will be same. Now see here. AD by AB is equal to AE by AC. Therefore, what we can tell here, triangle ADE is similar to triangle ABC by SAS similarity criterion. Okay? By SAS similarity criterion, we have proved this. See, if you will get confused, draw separate triangles and you can prove it. Okay. Now we will see the next question. See, student, the AD problem tells us that E is a point on the side AD produced of a parallelogram ABCD. Means first we'll draw a parallelogram ABCD. Okay, E is a point on the side AD. Here E is a point. Okay, E is a point on a side where on the side AD produced. Here E is one point on the side AD produced of a parallelogram ABCD and BE intersect. Here BE will going to BE intersect CD at F. Show that ABE means this triangle and this triangle, these two triangles are similar, we have to prove here. This triangle, this one big triangle and this small triangle, we have to prove here. These two triangles are similar. Okay, now see here, we have an idea about parallelogram, right? We have an idea about a parallelogram. Opposite angles are equal. Yes or no? Now see here angle A will going to be, angle A is equal to angle C and angle D is equal to angle B. opposite angles are equal in a parallelogram. That is, angle A, opposite of angle C is angle A, opposite angle of D is angle P. We knew this idea. Again, we know that opposite sides are equal in a parallelogram. Opposite sides are equal in a parallelogram. See, in triangle, ABE, in triangle ABE and triangle CFB. Now see, a student, in these two triangles, what we are here in this triangle and here in this two triangle, what we are getting same to same. Angle A is equal to angle C. What we can write, the reason is opposite angles of a parallelogram. These are nothing but opposite angles of a parallelogram. Angle A is equal to angle C. One angle we got now. Now we will see again, is there any common? Again, you just revise the properties of a parallelogram. See, opposite sides are parallel. Yes or no? Opposite sides are parallel in a parallelogram. Opposite sides are parallel. Opposite angles are equal. Opposite sides are parallel in a parallelogram. We knew that opposite sides are parallel in a parallelogram. Now see, here AE is parallel to BC and here BE is a transversal. What we can tell here? This angle and this angle are same. These two angles are same. Yes or no? These two angles are same. What we can write here is angle AEB is equal to angle CBF. Write down the reason. Alternate interior angles. As AE is parallel to BC. AEB is equal to CBF. We know that opposite sides are parallel in a parallelogram and opposite angles are equal in a parallelogram. By using that property only, we come to know the two triangles. If two angles are equal in a triangle, definitely we can tell that the third angle will also going to be equal. By these two things we can tell that therefore triangle ABE is similar to triangle CFB by AE similarity criterion. By AE similarity criterion, these two triangles are similar. Next, we are going to see the next. Say, student, the 10th question tells us that CD and GH are respectively the bisectors of angle ACB and angle EGF such that D and H lie on side AB and FE of triangle ABC and triangle EFG respectively. If triangle ABC is similar to triangle FEG, show that. We have to show this. First, we will draw the triangles, okay, according to the question, ABC and FEG, and they have given CD and GH respectively the bisector. And GH are respectively the bisector of EGF. That is GH. Okay. Now see your students. CD and GH are respectively the bisectors of CD is a bisector of angle ACB and GH is a bisector of FGE. Bisector means it will make, suppose this angle is 60 degree, you think this full angle is 60 degree. Bisector means it will divide angles in an equal part, here 30, here 30. This is nothing but a bisector. Here GH is a bisector. It will divide the angles equally. It will divide the angle equally such that D and H lie on side. D will lie on the side AB and H will lie on side EF of triangle ABC and triangle EFG respectively. If these two triangles are similar, they have given that these two triangles are similar. If these two triangles are similar, show that. If we know that if two triangles are similar, their corresponding angles are equal, yes, and their corresponding sides are in the same ratio. Now see, whatever they have given, we will write that things what they have given in the question. Say, it is given that, it is given that triangle ABC is similar to triangle FEG. This is the given thing. We know that if two triangles are similar, definitely their angles will going to be, corresponding angles will going to be equal. Angle A corresponds to angle F and angle B is equal to angle E. Angle C is equal to angle G. What is the reason? Corresponding angles of a similar triangles. Corresponding angles of similar triangles are equal. Listen, this is the reason. Now see, again what we have given, whatever they have given, we will write that. They have given that angle ACD, ACD, angle AC, angle ACD is equal to C. Now listen here, angle C is equal to angle G. These two angles are equal, yes or no? These two angles are equal. If these two angles are equal means, here CD is a bisector and here GH is a bisector. We can tell that angle ACD is equal to FGH. Yes or no? And angle ACD is equal to FGH. Angle bisectors. Angle bisectors. Yes or no? Why I am writing C here? Here angle C and angle G were equal. Yes or no? Angle C and angle G were equal. If these are equal means, if these two angles are equal, here bisector, we definitely we can tell that angle A, C, D and F, G, H are equal. Angle D, C, B is equal to H, G, E. Angle DCB. DCB is equal to HGE. This is also angle bisector. Okay. These were the given things. Whatever they have given, we have written. Now see, students, we have to prove the first one. We have to prove the first one. CD by GH. CD will going to belong to CD will going to belong to triangle ADC and also DBC. Okay, no problem. CD by GH, CD by GH and is equal to AC. AC and CD will going to belong to triangle ADC and AC by FG. That is AC by CD and AC. CD and AC will going to belong to this triangle and GH and FG. GH, GH and FG. Now listen here. We have to prove here these ratios are same. These ratios are same. First we have to prove these two triangles are similar. If these two triangles are similar, corresponding sides are in the same ratio. First we will prove these two triangles are equal. Now see, I will continue here. In triangle ACD and triangle FGH. Now you tell me in these two triangles what are same. Angle A is equal to angle F. See, in these two triangles what are same. Angle A is equal to angle F. Angle A is equal to angle F. Proved above. This we have proved. Again, what is equal? Angle ACD is equal to FGH. Yes or no? Angle ACD is equal to FGH. This is also we have proved. Angle ACD is equal to FGH. Okay, proved above. We have proved here. Therefore, triangle ACD is similar to triangle FGH. If these two triangles are similar, we can tell that their corresponding sides are in the same ratio, that is CD by GH is equal to AC by FG. What is the reason? Corresponding sides are in the same ratio. Corresponding sides are in the same ratio in similar triangles. Corresponding sides are in the same ratio in similar triangles. So this first one we have proved. Now second one we have to prove. Triangle DCB is similar to triangle HGE. Now we have to prove these two triangles are similar. Okay, see, is there any common here? Now we have to prove this triangle and this triangle are similar. Now the second question they have told, that is to prove these two triangles are similar. Now the in triangle DCB and triangle HGE. What is same? Angle B is equal to angle E. Yes? Angle B is equal to angle E. Again, angle DCB is equal to angle HGE. Okay, we have proved starting only. Therefore, triangle DCB is similar to triangle HGE. By which? Here you have to write angle. Here, these two are similar because of angle similarity criterion. Okay, this was the second thing we used to prove. Simple, whatever they have given, we have written and we have proved one by one. Now the third part, they are told to prove triangle DCA is similar to triangle FHFG. See a third one. In triangle DCA, in a triangle DCA and triangle HGF. Okay, in a triangle, now we have to prove these two triangles are similar. That is, DCA is similar to triangle HGF. What we can write here? Again, same thing. Angle A is equal to angle F. Proved, right? Proved. Angle ACD is equal to angle FGH. This is also we have proved. Therefore, triangle DCA is similar to triangle HGF by AA similarity criterion. Okay, see ya. In next class we are going to see the problems. Some problems are left in exercise 2.3. We will solve that, and afterwards we are going to solve. We will going to see what is the area of similar triangles. Okay, thank you. We will see in the next class.